What's up everyone, JayzTwoCents here, and I'll be the first to tell you that things like mice, keyboards, headsets are boring to do reviews on. They are hyper subjective and it's difficult for anyone to really come out with anything new. You slap some RGB on it, you call it gamer, and off to the races all the brands seem to go, except for Lexip. Because today we're taking a look at the Lexip 3DM Pro. This is basically if your mouse and your joystick had a baby. Before we get into the demo, let's take a quick tour of the device itself. It's pretty unassuming. It just looks like a fairly basic mouse. We've got some piano finish on here, not uncommon to see. We've got rubberized grips on both sides, so we don't lose our grip. A textured surface on top, making it comfortable. A rubberized scroll wheel, DPI adjustment button. We have a thumbstick. So this is like a little D-pad or a joystick pad that goes where your thumb is, of course, if you're a right-hander. We've got two buttons right here on our thumb as well. And other than that, there's really nothing all that special. Of course, it's USB. It's got a 3200 DPI laser sensor, and then we've got these six very smooth feet that it slides on. But if you look closer, check this out. We have actually got a joystick basically built in to the mouse itself. So it has all the functionality of a mouse, and of course, all of the axis adjustability, or I don't know if that's even the right term, we've got all of the axis control of a joystick. So what this gives us is complete control over movement of objects in 3D space. So that's why this is called the 3DM Pro, because this was designed to kind of meet a need for people working in professional work environments, especially CAD drawings, 3D artists, anybody that needs to move an object around in space. This makes it much more efficient and streamlined. But that's not all. You can actually use this in gaming as well. We will demonstrate that in a second. But everything you see on here is customizable. What these axes do, how the rotation works, the way it slides, all of this can be configured in the software. And we should go ahead and take a look at that. It's also pretty durable. So this is what the software looks like. It's pretty basic and it's pretty simple. Everything has a visual graphic to make it easier to learn or figure out which controls what. So here's your wheel sensitivity, your mouse sensitivity as a whole. In your options here, this is where you get to control what each one of these buttons do. So you could even remap the main clicks, which a lot of mice don't let you do. A lot of mice, especially gaming mice, only let you control the secondary buttons. But on this, you can even make left click do all sorts of different things. You got left click, right click, wheel click, forward click, back click, set DPI, increase, decrease, horizontal mouse, vertical mouse. So you can control everything on this. Now this is pretty basic. It's not something that really needs all that much explanation. If we look at the axis here, this is where you control what happens when the mouse is doing all those different functions. What I like is that their software even shows a little bit of a display or like a graphic showing you what this particular function is. So for instance, we got rotation right and left, and you can see the mouse starts to rotate or rock right and left. We've got transition left and right. So as you can see, we've got just basic movement of the mouse left and right. Transition up and down, so that's more of a forward and back. Rotation forward and backwards, so that's if we're rocking nose and butt, basically. And then stick forward and backward, you can see it's controlling just the little joystick on the thumb. So you can set what each one of these functions do. Now in the advanced, it's pretty basic. We've got our DPI configuration, so it's adjustable from 800, 1200, 1600, and 3200. So it's just those four steps. I find 800 to be, I'm okay with 800, 1200 is not too bad. 1600 gets moving pretty quick, and then 3200 is, my God, that's like the speed of light right there. So I find 1200 to be pretty usable. But something else that's neat here is you can control the dead zone in terms of a visual. So you can kind of get a visual of the dead zone. Everyone knows dead zone control exists on other mice, but here you can actually see it in a little visual representation. Now over here too, this is where your software is, and this is all the software that's supported out of the box. And as you can see, this is all professional types of software here. Most of it is 3D work or rendering, 3D graphics, but we even got Google Chrome, Google Earth, so you can move around Google Earth and stuff and get all of this control used right here in your browser. It even supports Firefox. Excel is kind of interesting. I'm not sure how we'd use it in Excel, but heck, whatever. But here's a little demo of how this works. So you got this little graphic right here, and as you can see, as I move my mouse in different positions, we are controlling this graphic. So if you were doing some 3D work and you wanted to rotate this thing, you could easily move it around without having to do like a right click drag or a space bar drag. you can move it all around however you want. And then of course the joystick controls things as well. So on the joystick side, we can, and by joystick, I mean the little thumbstick right here where your thumb goes. So in conjunction with the access control, as well as the joystick on the thumb, you have full control over this model, which is really neat. So this is just a little demo of how this could be used in a professional work environment. Now they do have a new mouse coming out. It's their gaming version. The 3DM Pro is based on the needs of a professional CAD designer, 3D artist, but they actually have a gaming mouse coming out. It's a lot more sleek design. It's got a whole new UI. It's got some supported games out of the box. And of course, it's going to have profiles for many more games as the library grows. It supports Star Citizen, Sims 4, League of Legends. So as you can see, a lot of games that require like scrolling of aerial views, making the joystick a pretty neat addition to these types of games. It's got a different sensor in it too. The gaming mouse is gonna support up to 12,000 DPI with more than four choices in the control panel. And the control panel, as you guys can see here, is a little bit different as well. It's a little bit more sleek. It's kind of what you would expect a gaming profile to look like. It has some carbon fiber here, some dark colors. But the refreshing thing about the gaming mouse design is the fact that it's not over the top gaudy. It is just a nice, sleek, minimalistic design that works both in professional environments and gaming environments, and it won't embarrass one or the other. But if you want to learn more about the gaming mouse, check out the description below. There's a link to their Kickstarter with all information and pricing availability, so you guys can check that out. But Jay, what about games? Most of us are gamers. I get that. And I've kind of found myself wondering, what game would I use this in? I mean, shooters, I'm not sure I see a lot of people adjusting to this with shooters. MOBA games or other games have lots of control or moving or scrolling around a map. I could see that working really well, or top-down type games. League of Legends seems like it'd be a good candidate, so you can move around the map without having to actually drag the cursors to the corners. You could potentially move it around. But then I thought to myself, simulators. Specifically, flight simulator is how I would use this. So here we are in Flight Simulator 10, and it automatically sees the 3DM Pro. It's right here in the dropdown, so you have mouse yoke, mouse look, and 3DM Pro. So it already sees this mouse. It's already got a profile for it. And it's got some of the basic controls already set up. I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of do this here for good measure. So aileron access, or that's our left and right roll, is going to be, we could double click that, and we are going to just rotate the mouse to the left. There we go. And then we need our elevator trim, or our elevator axis, which is, now I'm gonna go ahead and just tilt this forward. So it's X rotation, as you can see, so it called it something else. So that's X axis, which is right and left, X rotation, which is forward and back. So the only thing I am controlling with the keyboard right here is my throttle. And everything else I am actually controlling with the mouse right here. So as you can see, as I roll the mouse to the left, it's moving my yoke right here. Let me move the view down a little bit. There we go. So you can see it's moving my yoke. So as I pull the mouse back, or I push on the back of the mouse to make it rotate like a joystick, you can see I've got full rudder control and aileron control and elevator control with this mouse, which feels a little bit weird at first, but I got used to it really, really quickly. Which is kind of nice, because one of the reasons why I haven't been playing flight sims in a while is I don't have a flight stick right now. I just haven't had time to do that. But now I've got a single device here like this mouse, which is allowing me to now fly this airplane as if it were a joystick. And it feels actually pretty natural. It's actually not that hard. So now what we've got to do now is we've got to see if I can land this airplane. This is a beaver. Anyway, it's a beaver, it's a float plane. No Linus jokes intended, but we are gonna see now if I can land this on the water without crashing, because I've got realism all the way up. So we're gonna see now if I can land this thing without dying using the Lexip mouse. So I'm gonna try and land it right over here, right by that cruise ship. Fun fact, I actually took a float plane tour when I was in Seattle. That was kind of neat. So we're gonna have to thread our way between this sailboat over here and this little peninsula sticking out and the docks. I am a trained professional. I have spent many hours on YouTube learning things. So I'm a professional. Easy peasy. There we go. So, yeah, as you can see, flying this using the Lexip mouse and it, as if it were a joystick, absolute piece of cake. So if you guys are looking for a mouse that is truly different, then make sure you look in the description below. They have a gaming version of this mouse that's also gonna be coming out very, very soon. But if you guys are looking for a device that can do multiple things or is a joystick, any mouse in one that is mappable, customizable as much as you can imagine, then definitely go and check out Lexip. Once again, a huge thank you for Lexip sponsoring today's video. Go into the description of this video and check out what they've got coming. Guys, it's definitely worth taking a look at. So tell me what you think in the comments below. And as always, guys, I'll see you in the next one.